Well, last August, Victoria Osteen was in the headlines after a jury cleared her of all charges in a civil suit. Victoria's used to being in the spotlight, but for very different reasons. Take a look.
Victoria Osteen pastors one of the largest, most diverse congregations in America with her husband Joel. Over 40,000 people attend weekly services at Lakewood Church in Houston. Victoria says her heart is to help women and families reach their highest potential in Christ. She shares how you can live life to its fullest in her new book, Love Your Life.
Please welcome to the 700 Club, Victoria Osteen. Great
to
have you with us.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
You know, we all see you regularly, and you do such a wonderful job with the program that you do on TV. And then when you're in a public position and something happens to you that you can't always respond to publicly, everybody looks at that and says, what in the world's going on? How did you talk about loving your life? Was it easy to love your life as you were going through that civil suit that was placed against you?
You know, Terry, we all go through difficulties. We all have challenges in life. And I think one of the most important things that we have to do is to stay focused on who we are and the truth that lives inside of us. And you know, that's what I did. I just began to stay focused on who I was. I didn't let other things define who I was. You know, it doesn't matter if you've gone through a divorce, if you're fighting an illness, if you will just stay focused on the truth that lives inside of you, that God's never going to leave you or forsake you, and let Him fight your battles for you, then you'll come out on the other side stronger and with more wisdom than ever before.
What happened on that Continental flight? Good grief. That was the charges were so unbelievable.
Well, you know what? I didn't want to talk about it then because I'm not going to get into,
right,
you know,
well,
talking about people.
Well, it's not a good thing to do when the suit is still
well,
in
and
process.
Well, you know what? It's not my place to talk about people. I'm here to encourage people. I'm here to lift people up. You know, I'm not going to get into that. But I just know, you know, that a jury of my peers unanimously thought that it was nonsense and it was called a frivolous lawsuit. And you know, so that's all, you know, that I really want to talk about it because it doesn't help anybody.
You talk about being able to stay focused on positive things. Every one of us has things that happen in our lives, whether it's in our immediate families, our workplace, might be with friends, that try to pull us down from the place that really allows us to rise up on eagle's wings. How do you do that? How do you stay focused on the positive when the world is whirling around you?
Right. Well, you know what? You really got to get up every day and you got to just, you know, give your life to Christ fresh and new. The Bible talks about His mercies. His grace is new every single morning. And you know what? We get up and we focus. The first thing, we give our first attention to God. And you know what, we come to Him, we just, you know, ask Him to give us direction for the day and help us. And then you know what, we watch, we guard ourselves from what we're allowing to, you know, come into our life. Because I think that's so important. You can't stay above the fray if you're in the fray.
Exactly.
You know, so you have to just guard what you watch, guard what you say. You know, just keep yourself above the things that will try to pull you down. Now, a lot of times you may be in a situation where you're dealing with a family member that's sick and things are hard. You know, you may be going through some tough times in a relationship. But, you know, even more than ever, you need to just guard your heart because out of your heart is where everything flows. And you know what? God is so good. And, you know, you prayed a little while ago, Gordon, about peace.
Yes.
Peace is powerful in your life. Mm-hmm. And you have to come to the place where you can just get in the presence of God and you can be in peace because that's when you're going to hear from God. That's when you're going to be able to distinguish what direction to go. And you got to remember, God said He'll never leave you or forsake you. So it may seem out of control, but you got to realize God is in control.
Did you always have this ability to see the positive and hang on to it? I mean, I know when you were a child, you wrote a note that you found many years later that sort of expressed positive feelings about yourself, even as a little one. I mean, a lot of people don't have that. Where do you think that came from in your life?
Well, I really believe I was fortunate enough to be raised in a good Christian home. My mother and father, you know, they loved us. They took care of us. They spoke positive words into us. I think that's one of the greatest gifts you can give to your children is just that affirmation and support. You know, I never felt like I had to perform. Mm-hmm. You know, I felt like they loved me in spite of, you know, the little things. My value and my worth didn't come from making a mistake. It came from because of their love. And so I think that had a lot to do with the positiveness, mm-hmm. the support that I received. But yeah, I wrote a note that said, I wrote a note when I was about 7, said, Mom and Dad, you know, I love you. I used to write the mushiest notes. It's like, I love you, you know. It said, I feel like we're important and I know that we are. And it was years later that I came across that note. Joel and I were just going through some things, and I was just amazed that I could have said that.
At 7, you recognized that.
Yeah, and it dawned on me, that was God saying, we're all important. Yeah. You're valuable to life. Your life makes a mm-hmm. difference, and it matters.
Most people haven't had the kind of childhood where parents are always affirming, always believing, always supporting. You co-pastor a church of 40-some thousand people. What do you see? What are you hearing from people that's the heart cry that they have today?
I think everyone wants to be loved and accepted. I think they want to feel the purpose for their life. They want to have good relationships. They want to be happy. You know, women, really, they want to have their family in order. They want to be happy. And so I think that's where people are today. They just want to find that balance and that happiness. And I believe that, you know, through God, we can do that.
Will you just tell us how you do that? A church of 40-some thousand people. You're writing a book. You've got children. How do you keep that all balanced in your own life?
You know what we do? We prioritize our time. We make the most important things the most important things because there is so much to do, Terry.
Yes.
As you know, you could be going in 100 different directions, but you just have to say, for this season of my life, mm-hmm. this is what is important to me. We spend a lot of time with our family because our children are 13 and 9, and we realize this is a season we'll never get back.
It goes fast.
You know, these
it?
Are the good old days, mm-hmm. and so that's why you have to live today to your fullest.
Amen. Well, that's what the book is about. It's called Love Your Life, Living Happy, Healthy, and Whole. It's available nationwide. There are all kinds of wonderful things in here, 11 ways to love your life, lots of specific admonitions to all of us of ways that we can live a life that's truly victorious. And it's written by our guest, Victoria Osteen, so get a hold of it. We've got a little fact sheet for you about the 11 ways to love your life. We've kind of put it together in a concise form. If you'd like that, it's available just by calling 1-800-716-FACT, or you can log on to cbn.com and get it that way. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It has been my honor.
God bless you.